Hello and welcome to VCC TV. This is Aarti Singh and we have with us today Ashish Sharma, VP Finance at iFinance, Alok Mittal, co-founder and CEO at Indifi Technologies, and Ruchi Kalra, co-founder at OfBusiness. First it was mobile wallet and now the buzz is all around lending. What do you see in 2018? What's going to be in the fintech space?
So I think the buzzword, according to us, and that's what you would like to hear, is a lot of lending to micro enterprises using technology. I mean, how much of that is just fintech or a hybrid model is yet to be seen.
So two predictions. One, I think between payments, which is the wallet play, and lending, I think there is a wave of insurance that has taken off. Let's see, on which side it's currently. I think you'll see more news on insurance in 2018. I also believe that in the lending space, you might see a little bit of a rationalization on fintech. I think there's, in my view, on lending fintech, there is perhaps too much buzz right now. Mm-hmm. And I would think that there should be due for correction, even though players who are solving the real pain point should continue to grow and consolidate through 2018. So those would be my two picks.
I will agree with Alok there. I mean, insurance is definitely one play, and maybe we'll see a lot of the fintech innovations merging with the incumbent banks in the coming next year or so, and hence the innovation actually happening with the larger institutions as well. And at the same time, lending is one of the three oldest professions, you could say, or institutions, right? So whatever is the buzzword or not, lending is here to stay ever, right? As the country grows, lending will stay ever. Buzzword is an interesting way to put it, so maybe insurance will be my bet as well for the buzzword.
My question is, you all in a way collaborate with banks to operate in this space, but at the same time it is also said that new age fintech firms are posing threat to banks. How do you all see this?
No, I don't think that is the case. So, honestly, I think the banks in India are very, very small, or the bankers in India are very, very small. If you look at other developed markets, there was almost a lag of 5 to 6 years between when the fintech firm started being meaningful and when banks caught up to it. Mm-hmm. In India, that is happening simultaneously. Okay. So I think banks will partner with fintech companies, but at the same time, they will also develop their in-house capabilities. Because like it or not, they've got millions of customers that they already have. Mm-hmm. And their experience, the efficiency on that business, cross-sell on that business, all of those things are leverage points that banks will not overlook. Mm-hmm. So I think you will see investment from banks, both on partnerships as well as in-house capability.
I think banks should look at fintech more in a positive sense, because either they can reduce their cost of origination somewhere, or servicing, or NBFCs like us can be good customers for them. We are paying them interest as well, so I think we are a good customer for them.
As I was saying earlier, it's about a partnership. Mm-hmm. And yes, I think the private banks have caught up much faster. The public sector banks, obviously, with however the structure evolves in the next 2 to 3 years as to who are the top 4 or 5 public sector banks as they emerge. There is an effort and realization that they have to do things differently. Mm-hmm. And that will take them in the direction of either a partnership or small acquisitions on some kind of solutions. Mm-hmm. But it'll still stay a partnership.
Now, government has released their master guidelines for both PPI as well as P2P. So I think, they are looking at fintech sector as a whole very seriously now. So how is government responding to this lending sector?
Right now, there's a lot of caution. I would say RBI, not government. There is a lot of caution. The P2P guidelines seem fairly constraining at this point in time. And so there is a concern within the industry of whether they allow innovation to happen or not. Mm-hmm. From what we've seen of the regulator in the past, they generally are very supportive mm-hmm. of innovation in these segments, because MSME lending and the job growth that can come from there are real concerns for the country as a whole, not just for innovation, right, for its own sake. So our hope and expectation is that regulations will be progressive, they will allow for innovation. But the approach might be to make sure that some of these things don't, blow out of hand. In China, there was one P2P lender which lost $8 billion in fraud. Mm-hmm. Right? So that is certainly not the kind of outcome that the central bank here is going to allow to happen.
Mm-hmm. Same thoughts, actually.
In fact, I would just add to what he's saying. Government has been pretty supportive. The entire idea of Mudra Bank, that's the exact customer segment that we are serving, a Kirana store, 50,000 to 10 lakh, that kind of a customer. They have been pretty supportive. We have seen a lot of support from, you know, both government, RBI, as well as, you know, the PSU banks, as I had said. I think what additionally, probably to, you know, give a thrust to this sector, what is required is, as I said, there is a parity that needs to come. Mm-hmm. Because if I am, if the goal is financial inclusion, I am servicing that kind of a segment. Me going and servicing that segment is not priority sector. By me, I mean an NBFC. Mm-hmm. But a bank doing the same thing, I'm lending 50,000 to a Kirana store is not priority. A bank lending 50,000 is a priority sector. And the cost difference is there because it is a priority sector. So I think that parity has to come somewhere, and it's already existing in, say, microfinance business. So it's not unheard of. So there's a precedence in a similar space. But that being said, I think there's a lot of focus. Mudra Bank, SIDBI, they have been, you know, pretty up there doing stuff for this segment because it is required. This is a segment that will generate a lot of jobs.
Mm-hmm. Any closing note?
I think we're looking forward to some of these plays scaling and maturing over the next 12 to 18 months. I think as an industry, it is important that we earn our stripes.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm very encouraged with the progress that some of us have made in the ecosystem.
Mm-hmm.
Today, you know, banks take fintech players seriously because there's some, you know, proof of concept that has been demonstrated to them. The challenge now is to, you know, scale that up and show the maturity of handling credit, right? Those elements of a pure lending business.
Right.
But I'm very positive that in the next 12 to 18 months, you know, the fintech lending players will come into their own.
And I think the push in terms of product innovation that we actually referred to during the conversation is something that will actually even get the banks to think about things differently, and even existing NBFCs to think about it differently, because there was a full phase wherein everybody said, okay, let's start giving loans against property, and LAP became the focus of NBFCs, and then banks saw that opportunity and they just slashed the rates. But now whatever people are doing is very different and unique in the way, in terms of merging technology, whether it's for underwriting, whether it's for that matter acquisition itself, whether it's for building a new product. And those are innovations which will stay, whether it's with the NBFC or the banks, but it's great for the ecosystem to learn from each other actually.
Yep. I think I'm pretty excited because the pace of change in this segment, I think it's neck-breaking. That fortunately there's no right or wrong model. It will evolve over a period of time, but as they said, you know, it is a business that is going to thrive. You will see a lot of you know, changes. There would be a unique value proposition of whoever is coming in. There would be a lot of purpose-driven lending as well, you know, into this segment to bring in real financial inclusion. But I think there's a lot of action happening, and only time will tell which exact business model will sustain.
Sure. Thank you so much for joining us. And it was really a pleasure talking to you guys.